Technology is going through the biggest transformation in its history, with 5G and fibre infrastructure critical to the future. Here at Total Telecom TV, I'm joined today by Ankit Agarwal, Director of Sterlite Technologies, who has led the company to successfully providing solutions to Tier 1 operators around the world. Ankit, thanks for joining us at Total Telecom. One of the big things that all these Tier 1 operators are facing at the moment is obviously 5G.
Yes.
What are some of the benefits that end users will eventually see from 5G?
So it's clearly a very, very interesting and exciting opportunity. If we just step back and look at telecom operators globally, you know, we've largely seen that as the world has moved from 3G to 4G and to 5G, essentially voice has become free and the operators are monetizing data, where somewhere 80-90% of the revenue comes from data monetization. So even as we go forward, the revenue seems to have started to plateau and operators themselves are looking for new revenue models. This itself also presents a very exciting opportunity with 5G because you're going to have a very, very unique and differentiated service, which is very, very different from a 4G experience. You will have speeds anywhere in terms of 1 gigabit per second. You're going to have latency of around 5 milliseconds or even 1 millisecond versus somewhere around 50 milliseconds. So all the experiences that the end user can have will be vastly different. We're talking about virtual reality, augmented reality. We're talking about driverless cars, which will talk with the edge compute devices, and we will have local data center processing. There's even discussions of edge data centers even being at the back of the cars. In terms of quality of service, there will be differentiated offering where people may pay a premium for a differentiated quality of service. So these are some of the revenues which the operators are looking at, but in terms of the end user, it will be a vastly different world and a vastly interesting experiences. When we look at some of the emerging countries like India, we see that 5G could really be also transformational in terms of providing a very unique service for things like education, like healthcare, or even government services, where using the technology, using this high bandwidth, you could bring these services or experiences to rural parts of India, which would not be accessible otherwise. So it's also building and ensuring that this digital divide gets captured, and this is possible through the 5G.
And where does the fiber infrastructure come from in all this?
So we're absolutely convinced that 5G will require a tremendous amount of optic fiber. As we see our discussions with operators around the world, fiber has come really at the heart of our discussions. We see that while previously they were broadly discussing about networks, and still there's a lot of discussion around network virtualization, etc. I think across the board, operators have recognized the importance of fiber and building a vastly superior and more dense fiber network compared to even a 4G. In terms of our research, we looked at the 3G era move to 4G. We saw that there was about a 3 to 3.5 times increase in terms of fiber deployment when the world moved over a 7-8 year period. Similarly, we believe that starting 2020, 5G will be another 7 to 8 year investment cycle globally. Some of the countries that we see, China, US, Korea, Japan, they seem to have taken the lead in terms of the actions in terms of 5G. But across the board, we're seeing that the governments as well as the operators recognizing that maybe again in a 5G era, 2 to 3x further amount of fiber may be required compared to what has been deployed so far. What this also means is that the government has to work very closely with the local municipalities and really ease the deployment practices to make it much easier to deploy. In addition to that, the other aspect around all of this is ensuring that the operators themselves are incentivized to ensure that large scale of fiber gets deployed. There is a clear national mandate. For example, Europe has a certain amount of fiber it wants to reach. The best part about it is that theoretically, fiber has almost unlimited capacity. And so you can essentially put the same fiber network today for 4G and at a much larger pace, if you deploy that, it can then eventually be also upgraded for 5G services. So we are at the start of a very exciting cycle, we believe, for fiber. And we certainly believe that the industry, both the operators as well as solution providers like ourselves, are ramping up to make that requirement.
But as you say, it's a massive investment. Yes. Do they have the manpower to achieve it?
So that's a very interesting point. In our discussion with operators in India, even China, but equally in countries like North America, getting the permits has certainly been one challenge, but the other equal challenge, or maybe even a larger challenge, is having the skilled manpower. I think again here the industry, the government and players like ourselves have to play a very focused and a forward-looking role where jointly we build the right training programs. So this is something that again Sterlite has also taken a lead. We have built our own certification course and similar to a Cisco certification, and our target is in the short term to train about 10,000 individuals in India because we feel that the fiber networks really need to be built over the next 5 to 10 years. Similarly, we're talking to tier one operators and we see that this is a global problem. The other part that we are also working on is the fiber itself. Can we make it and design it in such a way that even with limited skill manpower, it can still be deployed? That's one part that we're working on, some of the solutions around G657A2 micro module, micro cable solutions, that with very limited skilled manpower, you can still deploy it at scale. And the last part that also the industry is looking at is, can we have more and more pre-connectorized solutions so that, you know, it's a plug and play and both the speed of deployment is higher and the requirement of skilled manpower comes down. So these are some of the areas which are an important challenge. I think together, if the industry along with the government looks at it, then we can solve it together.
But I think there's a real commitment, isn't there, to achieve it?
Absolutely. I think the operators and the government see this as essential move forward. And really, I think operators don't have a choice but to jump on the bandwagon. And I think the timing is great because we're talking about spectrum getting decided. You know, Qualcomm and some of the chip players are talking about coming up with their chips for the mobile phones in the next 6 to 8 months. So the timing is very exciting. And as Sterlite, we're very, very excited about what 5G means for the end user, but certainly in terms of fiber deployment, we see it becoming an exponential requirement.
Well, it's going to be a great journey. Thank you very much for talking to us.
Thank you so much. Pleasure.